Read the constitution provisions.
My lord, article 203 and then the High Court rules under which the administration committee is constituted. With regards to the district judiciary, each High Court shall supervise and control all courts subordinate to it.
Which of these provisions do not come within the domain of the High Court?
My lord, I think all of them, I think the High Court can.
Now, I pose a constitutional question to you. If we direct the High Court, are we acting in accordance with the Constitution? Are we undermining the independence of the High Court?
My lord,
because you see, we have to be very, very careful. We should also not interfere in the workings of the High Courts. Because there have been instances where the Supreme Court has interfered in the workings of the High Court and the results have not been good. So if these are the proposals, the High Court can implement them tomorrow.
Mr. Learned Attorney General,
hello.
First let us appreciate which each High Court is saying. What phenomena are they highlighting? Then we can come to this. Because if the institution, within the institution there is a culture that there will be no response, that judges can never be fearless. So before...
Well, then let's read the next one then. Let's read all of them. Which one are you reading next?
उससे पहले जरा अगर आप जस्टिस इजाज का नोट पढ़ लें.
Our order had restricted ourselves to the high courts. Now, if we read, each judge keeps sending things separately, we can read all of them, and of course, we will be benefited from them as well. But then our order did not say that. Either they said he should say, I don't agree with this note. Then it's a different matter. I don't understand. It's not a judgment that is being written. I write a separate note. The court has agreed. We can read it later. I think the High Court's...
Leonard, Attorney General, I think to appreciate Islamabad High Court's point of view, let us read it on record.
उसका कंक्लूजन पढ़ दूं या प्रीफेस मैं उसका आप कंक्लूजन कह रहे हैं पढ़ने का या प्रीफेस
पढ़ लीजिएगा उनका लेटर क्या कह रहा
है चलें पढ़ लें
जी आई कैन रीड आउट द कंक्लूजन फर्स्ट
नहीं आई वाज जस्ट ट्राइंग टू resolve this matter as quickly as possible, but yes, we can certainly read it. Please go ahead and read it.
Page 11 is the conclusion, but this letter obviously details certain facts and then the provisions, and then I can read out the conclusion if you mind. Conclusions. A.
Which page are you?
Page 11 of this note, sir, which is the additional note, but obviously the original is signed by the entire High Court. It's the full.
Gee.
Conclusions. A. Mandatory reporting with consequences for not reporting, followed by escalation to judicial contempt on inaction on the report. B. Promulgation of the judicial, within brackets, institutional code of conduct for all tiers of the judiciary. C. Revisions to the High Court rules. 1. To vest the functions of bench formation and case listing in the Administrative Committee in line with the Supreme Court Practice and Procedure Act 2023. 2. To eliminate misuse of administrative powers for targeted judicial outcomes. And 3. To reinvigorate the institution of the full court within the disciplines appropriate to a corporate body. D. Promulgation of code of conduct and ethics for the subordinate judiciary. E. Promulgation of rules for the conduct of judicial contempt under Article 2043 of the Constitution. F. Parliamentary hearings on reference by the full court as an institutional remedy adjunct to the contempt remedy. These are the conclusions. I may now read out the Lahore High Court, sir. It's CMA 3610, sir. Page 2, sir.
Relevant, pardon, sir. when the meeting was held.
ये लेटर अटॉर्नी जनरल पेज 7 में पैरा 2 पढ़ लीजिए.
ये पेज 6 से शुरू होता है ना इनकी रिकमेंडेशन, वो पढ़े ना, पैरा 2 से शुरू होता है
जी. की बात कर रहे हैं, सो पेज 7 onwards sir.
Yes, no, page 6 se niche se paragraph 2 se shuru.
Ji ji, paragraph 2, the participants thereafter turn by turn expressed their views in detail on the issue. It was concluded in the full court meeting as under. Under.
Give us a moment. Page 7.
One. All the judges of this court unanimously appreciate the above mentioned order, that is order dated 3/4/2024 in suo motu case number 1/2024 of the Honorable Supreme Court of Pakistan, whereby it is directed that the high courts as well as
this other is not really a proposal or suggestion.
Learned Attorney General, para 2 se padhiye.
It is considered to be very encouraging for the judges of this court that the Honorable Supreme Court has of Pakistan has passed the above mentioned order for the first time in the judicial history of this country to address the most sensitive and grave issue being faced by the judges of the superior courts as well as by the judges of the district judiciary.
Idhar ruk chahiye, what are they saying? That this is a continuing and persistent phenomena.
Hello. It was further observed that the principle of trichotomy of power is well entrenched in the constitution, which guarantees judicial independence at the institutional level, including the individual judges. The constitutional norms dictate that government, its institution agencies and agencies must respect and observe the independence of the judiciary. The constitutional guarantee of independence of the judiciary ensures rule of law, realization of fundamental rights and stability of the society. A functional democracy and civilian supremacy are affected and materialized in the presence of a vibrant, free, independent and neutral judiciary. The freedom granted to the judges to decide cases according to their oath, uninfluenced by other factors, is crucial for equality of parties before the courts. 3. It was further unanimously resolved that no one should get an impression that there is any division or grouping in the judges of this court, Lahore High Court within brackets, on account of minor differences of opinions or dissenting notes given in the judgments, because the impression of division or grouping in the judiciary is intentionally highlighted by some individuals on the electronic, print and social media for the benefit of the third party. Therefore, there should be a loud and clear message that all the judges of this court are standing united, and they also fully support the Honorable Chief Justice and Honorable Judges of the Supreme Court of Pakistan, who have been dealing with such like issues and other most sensitive matters of the country with courage and bravery.
And this is the paragraph which is very important, paragraph 4.
It is also unanimously proposed that the code of conduct of the judges of the superior judiciary and district judiciary may be amended, and there should be a complete ban on the meetings of the judges with the members of the agencies, save